So now the question is, can such locks prevent temporary update problem? What do you mean by this temporary update problem? So what is a temporary update problem? You know, we have taken again the same three accounts for better understanding and two transactions. The duty of transaction T1 is to transfer 100 rupees from account A to B. T2, what it's going to do? Transfer 50 rupees from account A to C. This is what is the purpose of these two transactions. Let's start with our process. We are going to understand temporary update problem without any locks first. So we begin transaction, read balance of A from the buffer. What is that? 500. And this transaction also starts and compute balance of A minus 100. What is this? 400. Write balance of A. So what will be written to the buffer in for balance of A? 400 will be written. Now this guy kicks in, he starts reading balance of A. What is the balance of A he will read? 400 from the buffer, because he has already written it to the buffer T1. Now compute balance of A minus 50. What is A minus 50 here? 350. 400 minus 50 is 350. Write balance of A will write how much? 350 to the buffer. Read balance of C. What is balance of C? I'll write it here. It is 1000. Compute balance of C plus 50. 1050. And write balance of C. What is written here? 1050. So this guy has transferred 50 rupees from here to here, whereas this guy still should add 100 rupees to account B. So what he does is he reads balance of B, that is 100, and then he fails. Failure can happen because of a network issue between your database and your web server, or it can be a failure of your database instance itself, a disk crash. So failure happens, or you think some kind of failure stop transaction T1. So once a failure happens, what is that we have understood? We have to reverse whatever changes we have made. We call that rollback. We have to roll back whatever changes we have made to the previous consistent state. So here, what are changes we made? 400, we have to roll it back to 500. So what it's going to do is, it's going to roll things back. A rollback will happen. The rollback will happen and it will revert back to the original 500 rupees that was there before the start of T1, because that is the norm. Whereas this guy is still not complete. He is well and fine, he is running. Transaction T2 is running. So what he is going to do? He is going to go and commit. So when he commits, what are the final values in the database? 500, 100 and 1050. Before the start of the transaction, what is that we had? 1600. After the transaction finishes, how much we have? 1650. So there is some kind of an issue because of this rollback. So how will you prevent this with locks? We'll check this with locks. So again, the same process we'll repeat. We'll begin transaction. So it is A transferring 100 rupees, right? T1, 100 rupees to B. And it is going to transfer 50 rupees to C, that is T2, 50 rupees. You start this, so what will A try and acquire? What will transaction T1 do? T1 wants to transfer 100 from A to B, so it will issue a write lock. Read balance of A, that is 500. What is balance of A minus 100? 400. Write balance of A. So this guy is trying, is going to write balance of A. Meanwhile, T2 wants a write lock on A. Will it be given a write lock? No, because this guy already has a write lock. So here he will be denied. This guy will go and write the balance back. What is the balance? 400. He will unlock A. Unlock A in the sense, this guy can go and acquire the lock. T2 will acquire the lock. Read balance of A. What he will read? 400. What is 400 minus 50? 350. He will write balance of A as 350. And then he will unlock A. What is unlocking A? He is done. So he will release the locks. Read balance of C. So he will actually acquire a lock on C and read balance of C, that is 1000 you will compute 1050 and write balance of C as 1050. So what is that is going to be written here? 1050. So this guy, he does a write lock of B, read balance of B. So he is going to get 100. Now he fails. So what will happen if he fails now? What will happen if a transaction fails? He should roll back, right? So this guy should roll back whatever changes he has made. So when he rolls back, what he will write to the buffer? 500. And then this transaction commits. So we use locks, we have achieved the final results. So what is the total amount left in our accounts? 500 plus 100 plus 1050. What is that? 1000. So what you end up is 1650. Are we correct here? No. So we still tried and used locks, but we failed. Some issue is there. So what is that issue and how can we prevent that? The issue mostly happens because of this rollback. So what is the answer to this? Is a protocol which is nothing but the two-phase locking protocol. Though we tried locking and unlocking items, we ended up with issues for the temporary update problem. So we went in for another protocol called the two-phase locking protocol. So what this protocol says is it has got two phases. One is the growing phase or the locking phase. Another one is the shrinking phase or the unlocking phase. Very simple protocol. It says if you are locking items, you just should keep on locking the items. You should not unlock any item. If you start unlocking items, you should only unlock items, but you should not lock any new items. So the locking phase is the growing phase, whereas unlocking phase is the shrinking phase. Let us take our exercise that we have seen just now, transferring 100 rupees from account A to B. What type of locks we need? We need a write lock on A and B. So we did a write lock, read, and then after we finished our work, we were unlocking. Again, we went and acquired a write lock. After we finished our work, we are unlocking. So what in a two-phase protocol they recommend is, when you are performing acquiring locks, you just keep on acquiring locks. So what you are going to do? In a two-phase locking protocol, you have two phases. This is the growing phase. In this phase, I am just acquiring locks, write lock or read lock. I am just going to go and acquire the locks. Is there any unlock in that phase? No. The main difference is, even after I finish my activity with my variable A, in the database I am not unlocking A, I am still holding on to it. And then I am going to write lock B. After I finish everything with B, I will unlock A and unlock B. So this is called the shrinking phase or the unlocking phase. So what is the rule? Once when I am locking everything, I should not do an unlock in between. The next rule is, when I am unlocking, say unlock A, unlock B, I should not just go and do another write lock of something. There should not be any other new locks coming in when the unlock phase starts. So with two-phase protocol, can we prevent our temporary update problem? Are you confident about that? Can a two-phase protocol prevent this temporary update problem? I'll be very short, since we have gone through this. Again, the two transactions does the same thing. Transfer 100 from A to B, transfer 50 from A to C. So what it does a write lock, read balance of A. Say it's a two-phase locking, so it's not going to release any locks while it's acquiring the locks. So write lock, read balance of A, A minus 100 is 400, write balance of A, 400. So this guy starts a write lock request, but it's getting denied because T1 is having a write lock. And you see, after this I am not unlocking because we are in a two-phase locking protocol. So there is no unlock of A here. So this guy will be in a wait mode. So he gets a write lock of B, read balance of B, still he has not unlocked A. So this guy will be waiting. And he fails here. T1 fails. So once when a transaction fails, what will happen? It should unlock and roll back. So he will roll back the balance to B, 500, and he will abort. So once when he is unlocking and rolling back, after that he will get the lock on A. So what he will get? 500 and then he will transfer 50 rupees from A to C. So are you now convinced that two-phase locking protocol prevents temporary update problem? Say for instance, take this scenario. In the growing phase, what this guy does is he acquires all the logs, write log, he keeps on acquiring, he denies logs for this guy. And then in the shrinking phase, this is the shrinking phase, right? He unlocks A, then he fails. After unlocking A, he fails. This guy was waiting, right? Immediately he goes and grabs a lock on that. So he has already updated it as 400. He unlocked, before unlocking B, he failed. So in that case, what will happen? Again, the same issue happens. Well, you have a series of unlocking processes. Once you unlock A, someone can go and grab it and you fail. So again, still this temporary update problem comes into picture. So you understood the problem here. You can unlock and then fail. So what is the solution for this? There are some variations to two-phase locking, strict two-phase locking and rigorous two-phase locking. So what strict two-phase locking says is, do not release your write logs until you commit the transaction. So I will be holding on to my logs till I commit the transaction. That is, the write log alone I will be holding on to. Whereas rigorous two-phase locking is very strict. He says, I will not release either a read log or a write log until I commit. So still I commit, I will be holding on to my logs. Do you understand these two things? Strict two-phase locking says, until I commit, I will not release the write log. Rigorous two-phase locking says, release all the logs only after commit. How you prevent this temporary update problem now? I am not going to say unlock A, unlock B and commit. When I commit, I will release the logs. So still I commit, this guy cannot read any of the partial updates made by transaction T1. So commit will release the logs for the transaction. Can we see a demo on how transaction logs happen in Oracle?